Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope all is well. After vacation, it's a time to enter the school with new energy and new ideas. So let us start our science class. The first lesson is plants and animals. So the first lesson is plants and animals. In lower classes, you have already learned the two types of things. So first one is living things and the second one is non-living things. So living things means the things that have life are called living things. Non-living things means the things that do not have any life. So give example for living things. Plants and animals are examples of living things. Example for non-living things are wood, plastic, rock, etc. So these are examples of non-living things. So in living things that include plants and animals. So let us consider this is a plant and this is an animal. So did you see any similarities between these two living things? Yes. These two living things need food. Then they grow, they breathe, and also both living things, that means plants and animals, reproduce. Then after, both plants and animals also die. So these are the similarities between plants and animals. So let us examine the similarities between plants and animals. So the first one is both plants and animals need food. Then both plants and animals grow. Third one, they feed. Fourth one, both plants and animals reproduce. Then fifth one, both plants and animals breathe. Then the last one is that die. So these are the similarities between plants and animals. So let us discuss the similarities between these living things. So the first one is both living things need food. So the first one is food. Only green plants prepare their food. So they are called producers of the world. So only the green plants have the capacity to prepare their own food. So they are called producers of the world. So in lower classes you have already learned that a green color pigment is present in the leaf. So they can appear green in color. So that pigment is known as chlorophyll. So that pigment is known as chlorophyll. So with the help of chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, water and sunlight, the green plants prepare their food. That food is known as starch. In this process, the green plants release oxygen. So this process of food making is known as photosynthesis. So this step, photosynthesis, you have already learned in the lower classes. So green plants prepare their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll and sunlight. That food name is starch. So in this process they can release oxygen. So this process is known as photosynthesis. Is it clear? So the food making process is entirely different from plants and animals. So in animals, mainly based on the food habit, animals are divided into three types. So based on food habit, animals are divided into three types. So the first one is herbivores, second one is carnivores, and the last one is omnivores. Did you heard the term herbivores? So plant eating animals are called herbivores. So give example for herbivores. Elephant, cow, goat, etc. Examples of herbivores. Then the second one is carnivores. So some animals eat the flesh of another animals. That are called carnivores. Give example for carnivores. Lion and tiger are examples of carnivores. Then the last one is omnivores. So in omnivores, they can eat both plants and the flesh of another animals. Give example for omnivores. Deer, crow, vultures are examples of omnivores. So based on food habit, animals are divided into three types: herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Thank you.